many people are still in doubt as to the exact reason why we are at war. They would like perhaps to see more clearly why we should have joined in at all when the nations on the continent were quarreling, and why it is really worth our while to spend so much of our wealth and send all the best of our manhood out to fight. These questions were clearly and shortly answered in a letter which appeared in the Times newspaper on August the 31st. The letter contained a statement explaining exactly what this war means to Britain and to the world. And the editor of the Times has allowed it to be reproduced. This is the statement. Why Britain is at war? For three reasons. First, to save her good name. Second, to save the life of herself and of her empire. Third, to save the freedom of the democracies of Europe. First, the war started as a mere quarrel between Austria and Serbia. When Germany seized the chance she had been waiting for to make an unprovoked assault on France, who is simply our friend and relies upon our loyalty, we could not simply look on. But there is a stronger reason yet. Germany and Britain had both by treaty solemnly taken Belgium under their protection and promised her safety and independence. This treaty the Germans have wantonly broken. The better to invade France, they have attacked and massacred the peaceful Belgians. The King of the Belgians appealed to us for help, knowing that we believed in honorable dealings. If we had refused it, the name of Britain would never have stood high again. To us who are now living, future ages would point as having brought our country into discredit and lost her good repute among the nations of the world. Second, there is no secret about the avowed intentions of the German Emperor. They are first to wipe out France as a nation, then to turn to Britain, strip her of her trade and her colonies, and trample our rights and liberties underfoot. We should certainly be treated with the same brutal violence with which she has treated the Belgians. If we do not strain every nerve, Britain may be reduced to the position of one of the smaller states. Her population will be starved into subjection and have tamely to submit to whatever insult and whatever degrading conditions the conqueror might choose. This peril is now upon us. A German army of enormous strength, determined and unscrupulous, is but a short distance from our shores, and any disaster to our navy may give them, helped by bombs from the sky, a chance of invading England. They would give us no quarter and no mercy. Third, the German principle of government is that the will of the people cannot assert itself. There is no free speech. The military class can do what it likes. The government owns the people, not the people the government. If Germany obtained the chief power in Europe, the progress of the masses, the cause of freedom and of equal justice and opportunity for every man would be thrown back 100 years. If your condition is bad now, it will be far worse if the Germans were victorious. Now you have hope of improvements in your lot. You would have no hope then. 100 years ago, Napoleon threatened the freedom of Europe. It is now threatened once more. Britain saved it then, and it must save it now. We have strong allies in the Russians, but the Germans are immensely rich and powerful, and they have laid very careful plans to crush France and Britain and defend themselves from Russia at the same time. Even if their first design has failed, they have vast resources both of men and material, perhaps more than we know. We have still an immense task before us if we are to be really safe. We can take no risks. We must never slacken until the great causes for which we fight have won a certain and lasting triumph. Our colonies have seen at once what this war means. They are sending troops and troops of eager volunteers out of populations very small compared to ours. The loyal Indians are giving freely both their men and their money. Life perhaps seems to go on as usual around you. Do not be deceived. This is the most deadly peril that Britain and Europe have ever known. Fight then for your life. Fight for your good name. Fight as Britain has fought before for freedom. Fight for humanity.